Hey guys, what is going on? My name is Yen, and I'm here to help you understand your everyday tech one video at a time. And today we're talking about the Apple Pencil second generation versus the Logitech Crayon. This video is gonna be kind of a part two to my previous video on this topic, but I didn't wanna repeat the same information I covered in that video. I would still go watch that if you haven't seen it. So what I did was I went out and got the iPad mini 6th generation and the 11-inch iPad Pro from 2021. This is the model with the M1 processor. So you guys can see how these devices perform on two iPads with very different display technologies. We're gonna talk about the advantages each one has and how much latency you'll be able to notice when you're writing on different types of displays. This time around, I got the special edition Space Gray Logitech Crayon. This used to be an Apple exclusive, but has now become available at other stores. So I guess it's not really an exclusive anymore, but other than the different color, it functions exactly the same as its orange brother. It uses the same Apple Pencil technology in the tip. It charges via the lightning port at the top with a rubber cap, and is designed so that it doesn't quite roll around as easily. The Apple Pencil 2, on the other hand, resembles its ancestor, but this time you don't have that stupid magnetic cap. It charges just by attaching to the iPad, which I think is one of the best features of the Apple Pencil. And as a little bonus, the new flatter side allows it to have a little bit more roll resistance than the first generation. The tip is also replaceable, so in case you ever wear it down or it ever stops working, you can always buy replacements in case that happens. And of course, while you're writing, you can quickly double tap on the pencil to switch tools. I usually have mine go back to the eraser. Both of these devices use the same Apple Pencil technology, so it interacts with the iPad seamlessly. You don't have to really worry about it not functioning. Things like palm rejection and latency are exactly the same. We'll come back to latency here in a second. Now, I had previously mentioned that the Logitech Crayon uses some voodoo magic to connect to the iPad, because it does. I can turn off Bluetooth and Wi-Fi and it'll still work, which is crazy. You can't use both the Apple Pencil and the Logitech Crayon at the same time on the same iPad. You do have to unpair the Apple Pencil in order to use the Logitech Crayon. But I discovered something really, really cool when I was trying to test the connectivity of these. So if you have the Logitech Crayon paired to one iPad and it was previously paired to another iPad, it works for both. Like, you can use it on both of the iPads interchangeably and write and do all the stuff that it can without needing to repair it every single time like you do with the Apple Pencil. Because with the Apple Pencil, you have to stick it on the side of the iPad that you want to use it with and give it a moment to pair. It's usually pretty fast, but this is just some other like next level connection that could come in really, really handy. Now, I covered this more extensively in my previous video, but the other functionality difference that these two have is pressure sensitivity. So for example, if you press down to make a thicker line, or you lift up on your hand a little bit and you start writing lightly, the Apple Pencil will detect that change in pressure. The Logitech Crayon does not have that hardware to do so. However, that does not mean you cannot make some thick lines with the Logitech Crayon. Depending on what apps you're using, I've seen the thickness of your cursor be affected by how fast you draw on the display or by the angle that you're holding the Logitech Crayon at. You can always manually adjust the thickness, but if you're doing things like drawing and illustrating, that's not gonna be very practical. However, if you are not drawing or illustrating and you're just taking notes, writing on the iPad, using Scribble, or if the applications you're using do not take advantage of that pressure sensitivity. For example, the app that I'm using right now is GoodNotes 5, and you can see that with the Apple Pencil and the Logitech Crayon, we're getting near identical results with the standard pen tool. Obviously, this can change if you use different tools or brushes, but for note-taking, it makes no difference. All right, let's talk about how these two devices perform. But more importantly, what if you buy one of the lower-end models of the iPad, like the iPad Air or the iPad Mini? Those have now been refreshed with a new design that supports the second generation Apple Pencil. Will upgrading to the more expensive iPad Pros really give you any advantage in this area? As you know, the iPad Pros have a more advanced ProMotion display that refreshes faster than other iPads. So theoretically, this should cut down on the amount of latency when you're writing. So let's throw these into slow motion and see what we get. All right, on the top we have the iPad Mini 6, and on the bottom we have the iPad Pro M1, both using the Apple Pencil second generation. And if you look really closely at the pencil tip, you can see that the iPad Pro does respond ever so slightly faster than the iPad Mini. However, the differences are not as large as they used to be on the older generation iPads. This is playing back at 25% speed, and on the iPad Pro, it's just silky smooth. All right, now let's try it on the Logitech Crayon. Same deal here, the Logitech Crayon is paired to both of these iPads actually, and I'm just doing the test one by one, and you can see that it looks pretty much the same as how the Apple Pencil performed. It performs very well on both of these iPads, but it's ever so slightly slower on the iPad Mini versus the iPad Pro. Now let's stack these two up head to head. All right, so with both on the iPad Mini 6, you can see that the latency looks pretty much exactly the same, because it is. From what I can tell, neither of them pull ahead. They feel the same when you're writing it, so you don't get an advantage with one pen or the other. And on the iPad Pro, both of them get the benefits of that ProMotion display, so it's not exclusive to the Apple Pencil like you might think. It would have been such an Apple thing to do for them to make it faster on the Apple Pencil versus everything else. But thankfully, they did not. Sharing the same latency technology and how it interacts with the iPad software and displays make both of these devices equivalent in terms of performance. All right, lastly, let's talk about price. Retail for the Apple Pencil is $129. For the Logitech Crayon, retail is $70 for both color variants. Right now, Amazon has the Logitech Crayon for $60. The Apple Pencil is also on sale during Black Friday. I have seen this go down to about $100. I'll put some product links in the description below. This may change as time moves on, so do keep that in mind. But historically, the price difference between these two have been about 40 to 50%. So if you're trying to decide between these two devices and you're not really sure which one to go for, ask yourself this: is the convenience of the magnetic charging worth the extra money and worth that extra bit of battery drain on your iPad? Or would you rather save that money and go for the Logitech Crayon? You are giving up pressure sensitivity though, so if you're doing illustration or art, that might not be the best idea. But if you're a student, you're taking notes, you're writing stuff down, you want to just treat this as a pen for your iPad, you can do that with the Logitech. You don't have to spend that extra money. I hope this video was helpful. If you want to ask me some questions about tech stuff, message me, send me a question. Hit me up on Twitter at YenzyOfficial. I usually post my random tech thoughts on there, and I try to be funny. I don't succeed. If you like this content, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Peace. And I will see you in the next video. Peace. Peace. Just so you know, I'm doing this when there's no music in the background, so you can imagine how awkward that is. I really should have a mirror here so I can see how stupid I look. Okay, I'm done.